In this video, I am going to explain anatomy and function of suboccipital muscles. Suboccipital muscles or suboccipital. There are four muscles in this muscle group. 1, 2, 3, 4. These muscles are very deep, very tiny. However, they are so important for neck movement, neck stability, and neck connection. Let me explain their anatomy first. Let me explain this one. This is rectus capitis posterior minor. Oh my gosh, it's so long name. Rectus capitis posterior minor. Rectus means straight. Capitis indicates head. And it's on posterior part and small one. Then what is this one? This is slightly bigger than rectus capitis posterior minor. This is rectus capitis posterior major. Okay, number two. Number three is this one. This is obliquus capitis superior. Okay, this one. Then last one. This is obliquus capitis inferior. Right, you got it? Number one is rectus capitis posterior minor. Number two, this is rectus capitis posterior major. This is obliquus capitis superior. And this is obliquus capitis inferior. This one is slightly weird because this muscle does not attach to occiput. This one attaches to C1 and C2. However, its name has capitis. You know, this is how it is. Maybe ancient people thought this muscle attaches to occiput. Maybe, maybe not. Anyway, these four muscles are suboccipital muscles. They basically attach to occiput, except this guy. Then they attach to either C1 or C2. Basically, origin is occiput, except this one. Then insertion is C1 and C2. So, occiput through C1 or C2. Obliquus capitis inferior attaches to C1 and C2. Basically, they are on upper cervical spines. Then, what are their functions? Two main functions. One thing is extension, neck extension. You know, they are on backside. When backside of muscles contract, they do neck extension. Simple, right? Then, rotation. Head, neck, rotation. They are simple, right? However, because their size is small, they are important for neck stability. You know, these muscles are not big as trapezius. They are not big as sternocleid mastoid. They are tiny muscles. Because they are tiny, they have more important role for neck stability. Why is that? Because there are a lot of balance sensor around suboccipital muscles. What kind of balance sensor is that? That is proprioception. Proprioception is basically balance sensor. You are aware of your body position without eyes open, right? You can rotate your head without eyes opening, right? So this kind of balance sensor is proprioception. Then there are a lot of proprioceptions around suboccipital muscles. What happens if these muscles get tight? Maybe your proprioceptions, sensitivity of proprioceptions decreased. Maybe, or maybe tightness of these guys can create headache because now your awareness of body position decreases. So this muscle, these muscles are very important thing for upper cervical spines, head, neck positions, and head, neck stability. Now let me explain very important myofascial connection to inside part of neck. Alright, this is profile view. I'm gonna focus on this one. This is rectus capitis posterior minor. Okay, then what is this one, this white shiny structure? This is connective tissue. This is posterior atlanto-occipital membrane. This is also a long name. Posterior atlanto occipital membrane. Atlanto stands for cervical spine 1 because this bone is also known as atlas. Atlanto occipital membrane. This membrane connects occiput and C1. And this membrane is right in front of rectus capitis posterior minor. You see this? They are very close each other. Then what is in front of this connective tissue? There is spinal cord. This is inside part of neck. Then spinal cord is covered by dura mater. Dura mater, this is very important membrane for head and neck. Again, rectus capitis posterior minor has relationship with this connective tissue, posterior atlanto occipital membrane. This membrane has connection with spinal dura mater. Oh my gosh, what happens if your suboccipital muscles get tight or you got a trauma here? This trauma indirectly affects for dura mater. I don't say suboccipital muscles attached to dura mater. No, it is not. There is connection via posterior atlanto occipital membrane. This is very important connection. Plus, some anatomy researches indicate also rectus capitis posterior major and obliquus capitis inferior also have relationship with spinal dura mater. Rectus capitis posterior minor connection is very famous. Then posterior major and obliquus capitis inferior also have relationship with spinal dura mater. Now you understand why this area is freaking important. These tiny muscles are important for head neck stability, head neck movement, and important myofascial connection to inside part of neck. So important, freaking important. I love working around this area. Plus, one more thing is, do you remember there are a lot of proprioceptions around here? If somebody got a trauma here, his, her proprioception may decrease. Then, tightness of these muscles create tightness for spinal dura mater. Then what's gonna happen? Maybe that person may have neck pain or headache. Why headache? Because there is continuation from spinal dura mater to dura mater inside of head. I love this connection. This area is freaking important thing for head and neck. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.